Hello, that is me, and this is Jordan. Look at him writing away. That's Chris. This is our first lecture back after placement. Shut up, Chris, you pleb. Anyway, I was that bored. I just wanted to focus a documentary on something, and I thought Jordan would be our man. He's an interesting guy. I find him fascinating. And this is a documentary on his life. And how could I forget? This is Dan. This is not how he normally gets around the house, but today was his preferred method. Look at him there, obsessed with his Renault Clio. Constantly having problems with that sunroof. Oh well, better luck next time, eh? So here we all are. Dan. Chris. Me. Jordan. Moving into our lovely new house. It's alright, no. It's alright for Mr. Chu. We're paying him shitloads! The first thing we learn about Jordan is that he doesn't like cameras. This is Jordan in Happy Days Cafe. But after little persuasion, we bring him round to the documentary idea.
No, that would be pretty cool. I would be quite interested to see what you come up
with. I'd love to do it.
So after gaining consent, it now became possible for the whole public to see the emotional and powerful journey that is Jordan Rogers. Jordan,
what?
When was the last time you went to KFC?
Saturday.
What was it like?
I don't know. I was too pissed to remember.
Really? Well, in Glasgow.
Yeah.
Was it good? What did you have? Come on, you must remember.
I know I had Pepsi as my drink.
Did it sober you up?
No. I added vodka to the Pepsi.
You took in vodka to a KFC.
I fucking was, yeah.
I was becoming alarmed.
Is she living like
Jordan had alcohol issues.
Is she?
And he could sense I knew this.
Is she down? Mike, fuck off. No, now is not a time for recording.
Jordan had recently acquired a KFC balloon. And Dan deemed it appropriate to start tormenting him with it.
I swear to God. I'm gonna kick the shit out of you.
This was the first time we've seen Jordan get aggressive towards us, so we gave him a few minutes to cool down. I was worried, and I realised the sheer danger of this project.
I'm just trying to go. Ow! My little toe!
Jordan didn't stop there, and he was determined to kill someone that night.
I can't do it!
A few minutes had passed, but things still flared up again.
That's bound to be burning your fucking nostrils.
You dirty bastard, I can smell it now. In answer to Dan's question, Jordan started throwing biological warfare into my face. So I decided to leave. By the next morning, things had calmed down. And we are ready for lectures.
What? Yep, to speak up. I'm wearing a jacket.
Dan was having a heart attack. But it was only because he was sitting in the chair.
He's taking photos.
University was tough, but Jordan was keeping it together. Dan kept tormenting him, and finally Jordan broke.
You need to stop. No, no! I stabbed him, I mean, I didn't do anything.
Yes, this is our degree, but after pissing about with mannequins, it was time to congregate and go home. But we couldn't leave without Dan, so we waited for him. And finally, he turned up.
Hello.
It was a hard day at university, but we were all excited to get back to the house, especially Jordan, that would play around with my candles.
What are you doing?
Swaying on a mic.
Swaying on a mic? Oh shit, I'm supposed to be seeing him tonight.
Familiar pattern. Jordan always resorts to violence.
Oh shit! Fuck!
Jesus!
Over there.
Hey, how do you feel now? Do you feel like a big man?
Yes, I do. Are you burnt?
No.
No, you're on fire!
Once again, things were getting quite threatening, so I gave him a few more moments just to chill. Another way Jordan loves to relax is by spending hours and hours on the phone. Where's my manners? This is our neighbour Chav, and he lives with Charlotte and Liam, and, well, Ryan Farter once upon a time.
Welcome to my documentary.
It's Chav. It's Chav.
You should just make a documentary of our lives. I'll make a sitcom of our lives.
Scenario.
Scenario.
Are you going then or not?
Going where, Charlotte?
How you feeling with the candle? Excuse me, that's my candle.
I'll meet you up front of that.
Yeah, who's driving?
Hi.
It's one of many Jordan songs.
Instead of a KFC, Javard had recommended the chicken shop in Plumstead.
And behave.
I thought we should get 5 chicken steak burgers and 2 fries for 6 quid.
Yeah, Jordan's.
For most people, it's sex, drugs, and rock and roll. Jordan, violence, booze, and fried chicken.
Do you know what your love is doing to me, baby? Do you know how I really feel about you? Do you know what your love is doing to me, baby? Do you know how I really feel about you? Do you know what you're
so cooking your own food is always healthier than fast food, right?
No.
So why is that then, Chris? Hang on, what's that you've got there, Dan?
What? You left a plastic chopping board in the oven, which you've now got to clean. Don't say no.
I thought so. So that's why KFC is more healthy. Oh, well there, Dan. Better luck next time, hey? In the meantime, Jordan was getting his hair cut, ready for a trip back to Glasgow. But his behaviour was becoming more absurd. I was very concerned at this point.
How'd you feel?
Where are you going?
Glasgow.
Looking forward to it?
Yeah,
can't do it. Choo choo.
Fuck off. Emotions were high already, and then Chris arrived on the scene.
This isn't a good time. Pleb.
Yeah.
We were escorting Jordan to his main train station, but tensions were still high.
You're down.
Maybe it was a lack of chicken. Or lack of booze, but Jordan was becoming aggressive.
Hey, stop!
And for a transient period, Chris was being responsible.
Turn this car around.
You dare grab my leg.
I will.
Well, don't, because I'm not.
Jordan, you need to calm down now, yeah?
Watch closely and you see him grab his hood. He's reached breaking point. Luckily for Dan, he was not seriously injured.
Next station is Blackheath.
Clear. But I was beginning to wonder if Jordan's new haircut had an effect on his behaviour.
Look like a Taurus.
Guys!
Jordan never told me what was wrong, but I already had my suspicions. I thought he might have wanted a KFC. But like any other normal person, his main priority was to get his train tickets first.
You guys getting that right?
Yeah.
Jordan was at it again, and he needed to replenish his habit.
I got a Harry Ramsey, he's got a chip.
Hey, chip. That's nice. Chap. Supposed to get one back.
Oh, that's not a good thing, actually.
Jordan was becoming fatigued, and it soon became apparent that we'd have to terminate the documentary.
Glasgow Central, Corridor Tamworth.